السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. This is Najwa Husseini with Azadi News. EU makes available additional humanitarian funding of 41 million euros to fight the pandemic. Bangladesh ministers overlook pressure to scrap DSA. The EU will provide 41 million euros to help low- and middle-income countries facing an unprecedented health, humanitarian and socio-economic crisis as the COVID-19 pandemic continues to persist, combined with the imbalance in the delivery of vaccines. To help countries in Latin America and the Caribbean, the Middle East and Asia tackle the consequences of the pandemic, the EU has allocated 31 million euros for, among others, health assistance to vulnerable populations, support for the management of COVID-19 cases, and for building resilience in the local health systems in view of future surges. In addition, 10 million euros are allocated to support the United Nations Children's Emergency Fund in delivering vaccines to children under the COVAX humanitarian buffer. Commissioner for Crisis Management Janice Linarczyk said, "The EU has been leading the multilateral response against the coronavirus pandemic in several ways. Team Europe is a leading contributor to the COVAX, which works to ensure that no country is left behind. Through the EU's vaccine sharing mechanism, tens of thousands of vaccine doses are provided every week to those who need them in low- and middle-income countries. The funding announced today will help address the immediate repercussions of COVID-19, including for vulnerable communities like the Rohingya refugees in Bangladesh and the indigenous populations of Latin America," Linarczyk added. Government officials continue to insist that the country supports press freedom, ignoring long-standing calls from international rights organizations to scrap the draconian Digital Security Act as it infringes the right to freedom of expression. According to BSS State Minister for Cultural Affairs K.M. Khalid on Saturday said, the government was determined to uphold the freedom of the press. A day earlier, Fisheries and Livestock Minister S.M. Riza Ulkarim championed Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina's efforts to develop the media in the country. On the other hand, rights activists and organizations have been critical of the DSA since it came into force in 2018. The act contains several provisions that are vague and open to interpretation, allowing for it to be abused to shut down journalists and other dissenting voices, they say. According to UK-based rights organisation Article 19, at least 198 DSA cases were filed against 451 people in 2020. Among them, 75 journalists were charged in 41 cases and 32 were arrested. As recently as June 9, a former Awami League lawmaker in Pabna sued a local journalist under the Digital Security Act (DSA) over a news report. Kandakar Azizul Haq Arzu, the former Pabna 2 MP, filed the case against Shaukat Afroz Asad, a local correspondent for Samoy TV, the daily Bangladesh Pratidin, and online portal BDNews24.com. Local journalists' bodies expressed outrage over the incident, alleging that the former lawmaker was trying to stop news from coming out through illegal means. On August 6, New York-based Independent Media Watchdog Committee to Protect Journalists, CPJ, urged the authorities in Bangladesh to immediately cease harassing two Rohingya journalists over their reports on Rohingya refugees. The two journalists in question are brothers and colleagues, Saiful Erkin, a reporter, and Mohammed Aziz Erkin, a camera operator, CPJ mentioned in a statement. The brothers cover Rohingya refugees for the YouTube channel of a Rohingya news website. Quoting Aziz Erkin, the CPJ said the Office of the Refugee Relief and Repatriation Commissioner, RRRC, ordered police to arrest him after he participated in a meeting between Rohingya refugees, the UN officials, and officials with the RRRC. Aziz told the CPJ that the officers referenced videos he and his brother had produced for the YouTube channel and did not name specific reports. This is today's news. To get more updates about Rohingya, subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the notification bell. Visit our website azadtvnews.com and follow our social media accounts. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.